Hello there. Welcome to part two of our alarm shelving videos for iFIX 6.0. We'll talk today about the runtime side of alarm shelving. So in our previous video, we talked about how you set up alarm policies for a given set of tags that you want to be able to shelve. Now, if I go to runtime, I'll see those policies in action. So I'm going to switch to runtime. And you can see here that I have a number of alarms that have shown up. And we also saw over here that we had set up AI1 and DI1 to have shelf policies and made them shelvable. So you can see here that I've got AI1 in alarm, and I can now shelf that alarm. And this shows you the options that you configured in your policy. So by default, we get the default preset duration. So if I click shelf and I want to just take the default down for a day, I can go ahead and just shelve that. I can also choose to shelf it for the max duration of 760 hours, or potentially I want to only snooze it for a shorter time, or shelve it for a shorter time. So I'm going to just assume that I'm going to take the preset duration in this case. So you can see in my alarm summary, I have just my normal alarm summary values, but I also have a shelved alarms view here. So in my properties, I have the ability on an alarm summary to say only display shelved alarms. And I can choose to show some of the shelf columns in my alarm summary based on, you know, the configuration of that alarm summary. So it's configurable, and I can have a view of only my alarms that are shelved. And you can see the shelf alarm is no longer in the live alarm summary, which is what alarm shelving is all about, is to be able to reduce that clutter and focus on the alarms that are most prevalent and shelf alarms that you want to focus on later. You can see here in 23 hours and 59 minutes, this alarm will return, its shelf duration will expire, and it will return to the alarm summary, at which time I'll probably be in a better position to deal with it. So the other alarm we have that was shelvable and will shelf is the DI1. So I'm going to shelve that one, and I'm going to give that a custom duration of just 1 minute, because I want you to see it come out of alarm. So I'm going to shelve that one. So now that's going to go into alarm the shelf summary for only 1 minute. And we'll see that eventually drop itself out. While that's expiring, I'll talk a little bit about also you have the ability to keep track of how many alarms are shelved, as well as if you look in the database side of things, you can see that we also track and you can see at runtime which alarms are shelved. So that's another handy way to see what's going on, especially if you've acknowledged an alarm and it's still shelved. You'll be able to see that here in the database. And you can see while I was talking there that this DI alarm shelf time expired, and it went back into the alarm summary where I can now acknowledge it. And that's the alarm, a quick summary of alarm shelving at runtime in iFIX 6.0.